districts and neighborhoods bearing the imprint from the colonial. The oldest section of town, largely restored, is visited by tourists from all corners of the world. Here, entrepreneurs have set up their businesses.
Havana's old section has become a major tourist center over the past years, thus favoring the private initiative with new opportunities.
Not far from the old town is one of Havana's first district, Guanabacoa, founded in 1554 on the eastern side of Havana Bay.
Que no dejen morir el patrimonio de Guanabacoa.
We can't spare efforts in preserving the local heritage. We must help it grow as part of our history, because this is the only way we can pass this patrimony on to our grandchildren.
A highly populated neighborhood in the center of town depicts what everyday life is like in most of Havana areas. People running errands, vendors on busy streets.
I consider it great that our city turns 500 years old, and we should strive for better living, unity, and honesty, and keep our city clean and bright and in harmony with its people.
Other districts built after the 1959 revolution boast a large number of Soviet-style condos, not so colorful as other areas, but they are integral to Havana.
Havana has changed me, as it has changed itself. I have made my own achievements here. Many Cubans from other provinces come to the city looking for a better future.
It's along this boulevard where Havana citizens hold their annual carnivals. This year, the big attraction included a colorful children's parade. And evening shows with singers and dancers on floats, people dancing in the streets, all wishing Havana a happy 500th birthday. Luis Chirino, CGTN, Havana.